everybody, Keith Olsen at the Trombone Shop at Schmidt Music. We've gotten a lot of requests to review the Shire's Q line of trombones. So again, these are instruments that are a collaboration between S.E. Shire's and Eastman. Now we've done some reviews of the large bore tenors basses, but we have not done their small bore tenor, the Q33, which I've got here. So I'm going to take a play on the Q33 here. So I'll let you hear it a little bit and then we'll talk about it here. I'm going to be playing all of this on a box 6.5 AL. Shire's Q33 is a 508 small tenor, so it's a two-piece yellow brass bell, kind of standard yellow brass tuning slide, lightweight nickel silver outer hand slide with nickel silver crook on it, and in a lot of ways, you know, just like kind of like the with the Q series, you know, large bore tenor with Q series bass, you know, you can definitely tell the Shire's influence with how it plays. It's very, very stable. As soon as you get a note to lock in, boy, it's not moving anywhere. And I think to a large extent, the timbre from the bottom of the register to the top of the register stays pretty even. Now, this instrument compared to some of the other, you know, even, you know, yellow brass instruments that we have in the shop right now, is a little bit on the bright side. And it's not overly so, and I think what balances it is it has a little bit larger sound. It does have an 8-inch bell, so it's a little bit larger sound, but there is a little bit more propensity towards the upper frequencies on it. And what I did find, I didn't do a lot of this in the recording, but I did play around with pushing dynamics, and when you really start to lay into it, it does get really bright. There is a little bit more of a shift in the timbre as you push the dynamic and it starts to get really edgy. You can still control it, but it does really compact down and get quite a bit more brilliant edge to the sound with it. I think overall it is, you know, it's really nicely responsive through the registers. I feel like I wish it had just a little bit more flexibility in the upper range. It's not bad. Certainly, it does a really nice job, especially even compared to some of the others. But again, if we're getting down to nuance, I wish it was just a little bit more accessible in the upper range, just a little more flexible. I felt like I'd like to have just a little bit more control up there. But it certainly did the job. Played really, really well, up there for a lot of the demands that I was putting it through. I think, and again, the other thing, like the Q-Series here, I think what it's missing is just a little bit of the nuance in the sound. And again, you could argue this is the same thing that differentiates that professional level instrument versus the custom professional instruments, is a lot of times when we're talking about the Edwards, the Shires, the Greenhoes, the Raths, on and on and on, there is a different level of complexity in the sounds. A lot of times there's a little bit more smoothness, it works with you just a little bit more, and that's what I kind of experienced with the Q-Series. They're great playing instruments. They absolutely match up with a lot of the other quote-unquote production professional level instruments, but there is a reason why that next level of custom instrument is priced the way it is, because it does these little things just at the next tier. So hope you enjoyed the video about the SE Shires Q33 here. If you have any thoughts about what you heard in the video, have any experience with this model, please feel free to leave those below in the comments. If you have enjoyed the video, think about giving a thumbs up. If you haven't already subscribed to our channel, consider doing that. We really appreciate that. Hopefully we're creating content that is interesting for you, and you can always find us on Facebook, Instagram, and other social media. So thanks for watching, everybody.